What's up, YouTube? I'm here at one of my favorite local junkyards, way back here in the back 40, and I'm looking for a Toyota MR2. I'm looking for a Camry LE, about a 96-97, like that body style, but I'm looking for the hubcaps and a couple of little things off of it. But I thought I'd videotape for a minute or so. There's lots of old, cool cars out here that you don't see anymore on the road, which, I mean, there is in any junkyard, but particularly this one, just because this one's so big. I mean, we're way back in the woods here, and it's just cars and cars, and it goes all the way out past that clearing up there and keeps on going, just car and cars and cars. There's another Camry right here, the backside of this Camry. Nope, nope, this is an Avalon. Oh, that's electric. Let's walk over here. See if they left us any goodies. Nope. That one's been... I can easily say that one's been depleted of its resources. It's of no use anymore. Old Tercel wagon. I don't know if you can see it. Walked into a tree, that's great. There's tons of Camrys out here, it's just finding the generation hubcap and stuff I'm looking for. Because like I said, I need about a 96, and these are all earlier 90s models. Someone even took the time to rob the emblems off of that one. Someone left clothes and stuff in this one, some shoes. There's a steering column. Is that out of this one? No, this one still has a steering column in it. And a stack of CDs on the dash, a big old thick stack. Nope. Nope. The other junkyard I went to before this one had a bunch of those hubcaps. But those aren't what I'm looking for. Like I said, I'm wanting the late 90s LE hubcaps. The ones with the little teardrops in them. There's a Corolla. Like mine. Get this door open. Oh, that door may not ever open again. But it's okay because there's no windshield. I wonder what motor this one had. The code's too far gone for me to read it. There's another Camry up there, and there's a Tercel. A couple more Camrys back there. Oh wow. Look at the Corona. God, that's a mid-80s Corona. Tell me how many of these you find in a junkyard. And it's not in bad shape either. There's a hubcap. Still not the one I'm looking for. Motor and drivetrain's completely gone. But look, it's a vinyl top, and it's not destroyed. Let's see if we can open this door. All the chrome's in good shape. It's got a gauge cluster. Look how good the door panels are. Even the seat's in good shape, it's just dirty. The headliner's down, it's an automatic. It's got that old car smell. That, and it's been sitting in the backyard with the emblems on it. grill's got a little busted place, but it's not that bad. But seriously, how many Coronas do you see in the junkyard? I'm not even sure what that is. There's another Toyota beside it. This junkyard's been here for a long time. I like this Corona though. That'd be a really cool like restoration project if you could find a motor and a transmission, because it's not been wrecked. I'll let you look down this side. You can see it's straight. The body's very straight. I guess someone didn't want it and just dumped it in the junkyard. Motor and trans got pulled for another one. Oh, here we go. Here's some more cameras. More like the generation I'm looking for. It's got those little squinty taillights. This is what I'm looking for. Oh wow, they stripped this one good. Look how mangled that door is. Let me take a step back so you can get all that. Typical of this junkyard. Wheels are gone. Look at that, guys. You recognize that? That's a Miata. Ooh. I hope those people are okay. So this is the generation I'm looking for. And of course, it doesn't have any hubcaps. And I'm not even gonna stick my hand in that trunk. Lord knows what's in there. It's a mass fuel tank. Doors wedged shut. And these are the generations I'm looking for. Good cars. Most of these probably got in here because they didn't service them regularly. These cars had timing belts, and a lot of people never thought about them. They just drove. Which on a timing chain is not as bad, but it's still not great, but it's not as bad. You can kind of, you know, get away with doing that. Look at that neat old hubcap. I don't even know what that's off of, but I'm gonna put that over here. That way so I know where it's at if I ever wanted to come back and get it. Some more Camrys. Wrong generation though. This one might be. No, this one's the wrong generation. They're all very similar, but just different enough to have different wheels. There's another MR2 back over there. I think this is what's left of a Corolla. Oh, look, a Celica. I'm sorry, a Corolla. An old two-door Corolla GTS with a twin cam four banger. You don't see any of those anymore. Toyota Celica GT. Look at this. It has the louvers, the metal louvers, still on it. I bet those are hard to find. You know, people need parts. I could easily work out something with you. I mean, I live locally here. I could easily purchase the part and ship it to you for a little extra charge for finding it. If that'd be something anyone would be wanting to do, I can do that. It's just enough to cover the cost and shipping and stuff like that. I could do something like that, because I know some of these parts are really hard to find. I couldn't tell you when the last time I saw an old Celica like that pass me on the road. Probably been a long time. And see, down here the cars don't rust. Like, I bet you some of these cars have been in this junkyard 7, 8, maybe even 10, 15 plus years. Some of these older cars. But they don't rust here. They will eventually. But not like cars way up north rust. Be. They tend to hold their paint and stuff much, much better. And don't let the elements get to it so fast. Well, we're running out of Toyota land. Now we're starting to enter Subaru land and Mustang land, and that's not a place I want to go. I want to keep those bad omens as far away from my car as I can. Let's stay up here near the Hondas to keep us safe. And just stay away from all those Rustangs. Oh great, now there's a probe. Now we're really screwed. Look at the old Audi Quattro. Saab 900. I told you this place just, it's huge. There's just so much. You know, I really like these Audi hubcaps. I wonder what they would want for this set of these. And there's two right there. And I think I saw the other two still on the car.
Yep.
Are they 14 inch?
Yep. They're plastic.
But they're pretty cool looking. A little flimsy feeling. Still pretty cool. If they had a set of bottle cap wheels, old BMW bottle caps, those would be really cool. I used to have a 325i that had the bottle caps on it, but I sold it. It's in the 60s today. The weather is supposed to warm up for about 3 or 4 days before it gets a little chilly again, but first day of spring, so hopefully, weather permitting, it stays nice. I was able to wear shorts today, a short sleeve shirt. This is aggravating, oh. Really hoping they would have one. This junkyard is actually so big, they have three different locations all around my town that I live in. They have one that's just for classic cars. It's called Vickers Classics. And then they have the main yard where they sell just mainly motors and transmissions. It's off the main highway, so it's easy access. And this one's kind of like, you know, miscellaneous parts. Like if you need window glass or a door or some tail light, something like that, this is where you come. And they have lots of Toyotas and Hondas and stuff like that to choose from. And not just that, they've got really old Fords. I think they have a couple Packards. I know they're rusty, but I think they got two or three Packards in the back. And the other Vickers Classics has some Studebakers, some early 50s Chevys, sedans and pickups and stuff. But I don't drive those, so which leads me to this junkyard for most of my pickings. Oh, look. Look at this. It had coilovers. Adjustable full-length coilovers. That's cool. It got wrecked, but... The guy was probably thinking, well, at least I looked good when I wrecked. In your little Acura. I should have known it'd be lowered. As soon as I realized it said Acura on it. There's another MR2 way down there, a white one. And now we're in the Nissans. And not a huge Nissan person. And let's just say they have a large selection of Nissans, which contributes to my not so much liking of Nissans. You need a parts, it's a great place, but it should tell you something. It should be a sign, you know. Well, I think this is gonna end my tour of the junkyard right here, because I've walked all down through here. I don't know if you keep hearing that big loud machine over there, the big bucket loader, but they're actually getting rid of cars. They've gotten rid of quite a few cars through here. There's an old Chevy, 50-something Chevy pickup. But he's actually gotten rid of a lot of cars through here. Ones that have sat here for years and years. They've been hauling them off and junking them. So, I was kind of surprised to hear that they were gonna do that. And they're not getting rid of all of them. They're just getting rid of the ones that are completely worthless. Like all the Nissans. No, but I guess this will end my tour of the junkyard. So thank you guys for watching. Y'all have a great day. Please comment, rate, subscribe, and as always, stay awesome, bros, and all the Camaros.